Jazz is thought by many to have been born in the dance halls during the Roaring Twenties, as if the art form sprang up overnight after the First World War. However, the formation of jazz was far more complex. The ultimate seeds of jazz were planted with the work songs and spiritual songs of blacks in the Deep South that were created during slavery and the oppression of Jim Crow racism in the United States. These early art forms were incubated in the early black church. Eventually, a 12-bar, three-chord musical form sprang from these early roots, the blues. Early blues frequently took the form of a loose narrative. African-American singers voiced his or her personal woes in a world of a harsh reality, a lost love, the cruelty of police officers, oppression at the hands of white folk, and hard times. The blues will ultimately prove to be the foundation of all music that was born in the United States. Some early key artists include Ma Rainey, Robert Johnson, Blind Lemon Jefferson, Big Joe Turner, and Bessie Smith. Bessie Smith's recording career began in 1923. She once auditioned for Black Swan Records and was dismissed because she was considered too rough. Smith emphasized and channeled a subculture within the African-American working class. Additionally, she incorporated commentary on social issues like poverty, interracial conflict, and female sexuality into her lyrics. Her lyrical sincerity and public behavior were not widely accepted as appropriate expressions of African-American women. Ultimately, Smith was nicknamed the Empress of the Blues and became the most popular female blues singer of the 1920s and 30s. She is often regarded as one of the greatest singers of her era and was a major influence on other jazz singers.
Come on.
Some key modern blues artists include Howlin' Wolf.
This is the one we made up a few years ago. You call him
Willie Dixon, Jimmy Reed, John Lee Hooker,
the gypsy woman told my mother,
Taj Mahal,
before I was born,
B.B. King,
you got a boy,
and Muddy Waters.
Gonna be a son of a gun.
McKinley Morganfield, otherwise known as Muddy Waters, was born April 4, 1913. He is often cited as the father of modern Chicago blues. He recorded several blues classics, some with bassist and songwriter Willie Dixon. These songs include Hoochie Coochie Man, I Just Want to Make Love to You, and I'm Ready. 1958, he traveled to England, laying the foundations of the resurgence of interest in the blues there. While the blues was enjoying its early popularity among American blacks, another art form would intersect with it, ragtime. Ragtime enjoyed its peak popularity between 1895 and 1918. Its dominant trait was a syncopated or ragged rhythm. Some key artists include Scott Joplin, James P. Johnson, Fats Waller, Earl Hines, Ubi Blake, Jelly Roll Morton, and James Reese Europe. James Reese Europe was known for his outspoken personality and unwillingness to bend musical conventions, particularly in his insistence on playing his own style of music. He responded to criticism by saying, "We colored people have our own music that is part of us. It's the product of our souls. It's been created by the sufferings and miseries of our race." his society orchestra became nationally famous in 1912, accompanying theater headliner dancers Vernon and Irene Castle, a married white couple. The Castles introduced and popularized the wildly popular dance, the foxtrot. Europe's musical exploits were a driving force in compelling the mainstream musical establishment to recognize the significance of black musical art forms. The blues and ragtime collided into a potent musical brew that eventually created the jazz era. This new art form went through its maturation process in cities like Chicago, New York, and the incomparable New Orleans, the hometown of such luminaries as Jelly Roll Morton, Sidney Bechet, and Louis Armstrong. Early key artists include Joe King Oliver, Buddy Bolden, and Freddie Keppel. Born Charles Joseph Bolden on September 6, 1877, Buddy Bolden was regarded by contemporaries as a key figure in the development of a New Orleans style of ragtime music, or jazz, with two S's, which later became known as jazz with two Z's. Many early jazz musicians credited Bolden and the members of his band with being the originators of what came to be known as jazz, though the term was not in common musical use until after the era of Bolden's prominence. At least one writer has labeled him the father of jazz. He is credited with creating a looser, more improvised version of ragtime and adding blues to it. Bolden's band was said to be the first to have brass instruments play the blues. He was also said to have taken ideas from gospel music heard in uptown African-American Baptist churches. Freddie Keppert was born in the Creole of Color community of downtown New Orleans, Louisiana. Born in 1889, Freddie Keppert was Buddy Bolden Jr. by 13 years and Louis Armstrong Sr. by 11 years. Keppert did not receive any formal musical training and may have been a non-reader who, instead of reading arrangements, most likely learned all of his parts by ear and used his powerful and imaginative abilities to improvise. Keppert became the most celebrated cornet player in that era. Unfortunately, Keppert failed to accept an offer by the Victor Record Company to make the first jazz recordings while he was still playing with the original Creole Orchestra. Because of his apprehension, the moniker of being the first recorded jazz artist went to the original Dixieland Jazz Band, an all-white band that went on to have great commercial success. Jazz was on a journey, and its destination would never be more thrilling.